Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Zeke, Dogumentary TV, YouTube channel for dog lovers. I wanted to do a video about my new puppy. He's a Rottweiler, and why I chose the Rottweiler breed over the Cane Corso. In terms of dog breeds, Cane Corso ranks very high on my list and was taken into great consideration before I decided eventually to go with the Rottweiler. Now, doing Dogumentary TV, I see a lot of different dog breeds, and there are a lot of great breeds out there that I could name that were suited perfectly what I'm looking for. So what exactly was I looking for? Well, what I wanted in my next dog was I wanted a dog that would be naturally protective. I wanted a large dog, 80 plus pounds. I wanted a dog that would do well in urban and suburban communities, because that's where I live at. I wanted a dog that would be good with children. I have children. Dog breed that was not particularly dog aggressive. In addition, I was looking for something that would be loyal, really healthy, and just an overall solid family companion. Now, you might say, well, that's the Cane Corso, and I don't disagree with you. Like I said, the Cane Corso is one of my favorite dog breeds and very easily could have fit into my family, and I very easily could have purchased a Cane Corso for my next pet. But I didn't, and here are the reasons why I didn't choose the Cane Corso. First and foremost, I think Rottweilers are a more intelligent breed. They seem to be sharper, easier to train. And that doesn't mean that Cane Corsos are a dumb breed or anything like that. Cane Corsos are also a very sharp breed, just not as sharp and as trainable, in my experience, as a Rottweiler. Another thing that I took into consideration in getting the Rottweiler, I find that Rottweilers are better suited for a home that has more than one dog. And I already have a senior dog in my home that I don't plan on getting rid of. So I wanted to play it safe and get a dog breed that would be more compatible in a multi-dog home. The next thing that I took into consideration was health of the breed. Now, health is always relative. You wanna find a solid breeder and you wanna find someone that's breeding healthy dogs. I know people who breed healthy Cane Corsos, so I wasn't too concerned about finding a healthy Cane Corso, but there are some problems within the Cane Corso breed right now that had me a little worried. And so generally, I tick the box for health or healthier breed to the Rottweiler. And that was another factor in my consideration for choosing the Rottweiler over the Cane Corso. And then lastly, aesthetically, I just think that Cane Corsos can be hit or miss. There was this one Cane Corso I think is absolutely beautiful. His name is Brutale. If I were to get a Cane Corso, this is what I would be looking for. And that he's probably not the best example of a working Cane Corso, but he's definitely a phenomenal show Cane Corso. And aesthetically, I like him. I think he's got a lot of bone, nice head, very well proportioned, and I like him. But he's kind of a exception. You don't see, you know, like maybe one out of every five Cane Corsos that I come across are kind of built like him. But you could find a Brutale. He's not the only one. Generally, it's very easy to find a well put together Rottweiler. And in my opinion, I would say 75% of the German Rottweilers that I come across, and even, you know, maybe 50% of the AKC Rottweilers that I come across have great physiques. So I just thought aesthetically, you know, Rottweilers look better. You know, a Rottweiler looks to me like a small bear, and a Cane Corso looks like a large pit bull. So I like exotic things, and I just like the idea more of having a small bear roaming around my backyard. So that's it, guys. That's pretty much how I came to choose a Rottweiler versus the Cane Corso. I could have picked an amazing Cane Corso to be my family pet, but by a few points, I decided the Rottweiler. And that's what I have now. I have my boy Roscoe. He's an amazing dog. Can't say anything bad about him. He's very smart, very loving, affectionate. He's he's fitting in. He's not, you know, he has a great personality. He's giving my older dog, you know, he's giving him a lot of a lot of hell, to say, you know, to put it politely. or to put it unpolitely, I guess, because he loves to play, and my other dog's like 12 years old, so he's not really into playing. But they get along, and they're having a great time, and he's bringing joy to the family. And I can't wait to just for this boy to grow up and be the family and home protector that I expect him to be. All right, guys, that's the end of this video. I want to thank you guys for listening to me talk about my boy Rottweiler, talk about my boy Roscoe. And I want to send a shout out to all the Cane Corso lovers out there. Cane Corsos are definitely an amazing breed. No shame in that Cane Corso game. All right, if you haven't already, please go ahead and subscribe to the channel. This is Zeke. This is Dogumentary TV. Peace.